Before we start for the reporting, let me show you another update. This one, I don't know the ID of this dendrobium, and I bought it like this, and so long it was hanged like this. It was mounted like this. I used to hang it like this, and suddenly I found today this coconut husk. It has come out of the pot. It has come out of the pot, and this is the root condition now. And now I have to make a decision whether I keep it hanging like this or I put it in the inorganic media with a smaller pot. I don't know about this particular plant, whether they are down facing or not, or up facing. I don't know about anything about this pot, this particular plant. Let's see what can be done. Wait for some time. Good afternoon, dear YouTube viewers, those who have joined right now here at Dhaka, the capital city of Bangladesh. Today is 24th of February 2020. Time now is 1630 hours. I am at rooftop at my workstation. I will have some updates of my some plants. I am very happy to show you those updates. And later part, I'll do some two of my plants reporting. They need immediate reporting. So let's start with the update first. This is the Chintamon Sunrise Mentor. This is the dendrobium species. It's a species dendrobium, and you can see this has a. Can you see? Yes. This has a cane here. This is the new cane. In my acquisition, after acquisition, this is the new cane I have, it has developed in me. And then the old cane, it started falling leaves, then it went on dormancy, and then you see it is giving. I don't know whether these are the flower spikes or some leaves. I don't know. You'll be able to know it better because I have not seen, but the flower I have seen, it had only two flower when I bought it last year. And if these all are these notes, these all are flowers, then I am really happy. They are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 flowers will be blooming this year if these all are blooms, I mean the spikes. Thank you very much. This is a nice one, and this has the new cane also. One thing to be mentioned here, that this was in my grow space. I never brought it to my rooftop. So it has developed. Everything that you are seeing is in the semi window under the grow lights I have. So let me keep it somewhere, and then I'm coming with the subsequent. This is a species Phalaenopsis. This is a Ascocendra crossed. And this is potted with a net shed. You can see the net shed. Can you see the net shed? See? So this was potted in a net shed, and it has bloomed just 2 months before. This was the bloom, and now again this is giving a spike. You see? Can you see the spike? You see? This is the spike. So again giving this, I have total 10 of this. I will put the name when I upload the video. Then after this I have the another update. This is a nobili, dendrobium nobili. This one is in a coconut chips, coconut husk, whatever you say. And it has got bud, you see. See, this is a nobili variety, and it has got bud on this old cane. And it has got two keikis also. Can you see keikis? Two keikis, and one keiki growing here at this node. One keiki growing here, and these are the new growths. These are all new growths, and you can see the roots developing. It's just thriving, so wonderful. So I am very happy with my waterism, fertilizing, feeding, and all these things. I really, really, I am happy. It is suiting to my environment. No black tips, nothing, beautiful. Anyway, this was the development I thought that I should share with you. And after this, I have the another surprise. This is a new acquisition, because you can see this is black over white. It's a dual potting. So I purchased this with this pot, with this potting media. This is the coconut husk. And after it finished blooming, from here, it finished blooming, then I put it in dual media. I put it in the dual media and I started watering and taking care of them, of him. Now I find it has got a bud. Can you see the bud? So it has a bud, you see. There are two buds joined together. Well, I don't know the ID. What is the ID? I don't know. I hope that after it blooms, maybe I might be knowing this ID and I miss the tag somewhere. Anyway, so this is another update. I have another update and which needs a repotting, this one. This is also a new acquisition. I put in a very small, tight clay pot. And now what happened? This particular plant, it finished blooming from here and also from here. After finishing bloom, then it started growing. And it started growing rigorously. I turned over the pot, then you will understand. You see? This is how it has started growing rigorously. And it is going out of the pot now. It is going out of the pot. Now, I have to take care of it. If I do not take care of it, then this root is going to die. So, what I am planning, that I will show you when I go for a repotting this one. So, this is a development and it needs a repotting, immediate repotting. So, another important issue, that is repotting of another plant. Well, I'll show you later on. So, let's move for the repotting. Right, dear viewer, thank you for stay tuned with me. And this is the one that I'm going to repot. And the technique of repot should be the same. I'm not going to disturb this root as it is growing. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this one onto this. How I'm going to do it? I'll put it like this. I'll put it like this, and then I will tie up this one. I'll tie up with this rope, this one with this one. So I'll wait for some time. Let me tie it up. And this is a very interesting way of potting my plants in my weather, because my weather has got a very dirty, rainy type. It continues raining. And during this season, rainy season, if I am not careful about my media, then it's going to play a very havoc for me. So that is why I have to take care and be very careful so that my plants do not get soaked over the time and remain soggy and the root keeps dying. What happened actually last year, most of my cattleyas, they were showing growths. At the same time, they were dying back inside the media, because of it was in the coconut husk and media was dying back and I was not getting any notice of it, because I did not even understand that media is dying back. So ultimately what happened, the new growth took place, but unfortunately there was no bloom, because normally the common sense says that a bloom will take place on a old growth, not on any new growths. So my old growths all had been dying back, as there was root rots taking place. So That has happened in my case, and ultimately very less number of Cattleya has bloomed this year. Those were bought last year, but those I have purchased in this year 2019, end of 19 and beginning of 2020, they are doing fine because I am taking care of them, of their media, and before the rainy season comes, I am planning to keep my media as it is. Initially, I thought of changing the media, I mean this coconut husk, to remove and then put the charcoal or brick chips and remove the coconut husk. But as I come to learn from Margaret that the Cattleya, I have too much of helicopter flying over my head. Every day I do a video, this time I find a helicopter. Please bear with me. Excuse me for the background noise. Although it was a nice noise of helicopter. I don't know, maybe a training flight. Anyway, friends, so what I was talking about, that so my media was not very comfortable for my growing culture, and I had to pay back. I mean, I had to suffer a lot, and there was very less of blooming. So this time I am not allowing the same things to happen, but nothing doing. This coconut husk will again get rot, but whatever, what will happen, this time the media, the roots inside of this coconut husk, they are almost dead, and the new roots has already emerged. So there is less of possibilities that it will harm during the rainy season, because last time it harmed, reason behind that, those were the new roots. So my tying up the smaller pot onto the bigger pot is already done. Now I will put some brick chips around in the same way I did here. In the same way, I'll just put some brick chips around. So normally what I do, I put a small layer first of small and medium size brick chips, and then I give this very small size, this size. I give this size so that they cover up the gaps. If there is any hole, they are going to cover it up. So anyway, I don't think this will work very nice, because this pot has got a aeration hole, side slits. So giving the smaller size around is not going to work much. Anyway, let's see what happened. I think I need to take care of this particular root. This must not be hurt. I made a mistake. This particular root must be taken care, because it is the active growing root. So I must allow it to go down below the bricks and grab the bricks. I'm not going to put any bricks underneath, because bricks might have to be very careful for a few days, so that these bricks do not, I plan not to make too many movement. I'll just fix it in a place and keep it there, no movement, so that that root do not get damaged by moving too much and get hurt by the brick chips. That is the main purpose, and that is the main challenge, because if I put them, keep them moving, then this tip will get hurt and it will be broken. So be very careful. I'm not giving any more because I don't want any big chips to fall down here and then touch this chips, because there's nothing to make tight packing and all these things. Almost the potting is almost done. I hope I have done the justice. Anyway, friends, now come to the second one. This one, which I was talking about, this one, I want to remove this coconut husk. I want to remove this coconut husk and I want to put it bare root. Let's see whether I can remove it or not without making any damage. If I can, that will be very, very fantastic. And I think it has some growing roots. It has some growing roots and those will cover it up. I don't think that I can remove further. I have to make it a dual pot. In fact, this time I wanted not to make a dual potting. This time I wanted to make it a only inorganic media, but I don't think that I'll be able to do it, because on the other side the media is very, very tightly grabbed. This side, it is not possible. You see, it is not possible to remove it. You see, can you see? See, this is not possible. These are dead roots. Can I do it? Okay, let's try. Let's see. I think I can do it. Yes. Yes. Yes, I have done it. Yes. Yes. And this is very easy. Very simple and easy. Now it is easy. Oh, finally I could make it without much loss. Maybe 5% root was damaged. Maybe 5% damage, and the active roots are still there. Active roots are still there, you see. These are the active roots. So it is there. So I don't think that this will cause any. I don't need to do any mechanism here, putting the hydrogen peroxide and all these things. Even do not need to wash it. I just put it here inside. So I'll just take some large brick chip and fill it up as usual. Fill it up as usual and now place the plant over here and put the smaller chips around. I'll put the smaller chips around. This is also need lot of care, no movement, because normally in the brick chip the plant is not very stable unless you tie it up. unless you tie it up, this is very difficult to hold it. Anyway, friends, I think this will do. I keep it like this for about a month. I think it will work. Anyway, friends, thank you very much for joining me and have a wonderful day. And if you have liked it, please give a thumbs up. Take care. Bye-bye.